Welcome, my dear learners, for this course on mechanical vibrations. In this module 1, we were discussing on damped free vibration and undamped free vibration. So far, we have concluded our discussion on undamped free vibration and we have started discussing on damped free vibration systems, wherein which we have discussed the effect of value of damping factor on damped free vibration analysis. That is, when the value of zeta is greater than 1, that is overdamped system, what is the system response? When the value of zeta is equal to 1, which is critical damp, what is the system response? And when the value of zeta is less than 1, that is 100 amp system, what is the system response? And we have also observed the system response curves in our previous lecture. Let us continue our discussion on damped free vibration analysis. In today's lecture, I am going to derive expression for logarithmic decrement. That is, today's concept is logarithmic decrement. Logarithmic decrement, which is denoted by delta. Logarithmic decrement is defined as the natural logarithm of ratios of two successive amplitudes taken on the same side of the mean line. Logarithmic decrement is defined as the natural logarithmic ratio of two successive amplitudes taken on the same side of the mean line of a vibrating system. So therefore, as I said, logarithmic decrement, by definition itself, it is the natural log of ratios of two successive amplitudes, x1 by x2, taken on the same side of the mean line. So hence, for logarithmic decrement, we should recall the system response of undamped vibrating system. So this is displacement, this is time. So if I plot the system response curve of underdamped system, it is like this. Correct? So this I can write it as x1 amplitude, this I can write it as amplitude x2, this I can call it as x3, and this I can call as x4. And from here to here we have one cycle, and this is termed as time period. This you already know, right? This you people already know. Let us take the time period for the amplitudes itself. That is, this time I'll call it as t1, and this time I'll call it as t2. And we have the time period which can be taken for two crests or two trough. Let me take time period here for better understanding of the derivation. Let us take this as time period tau, which can be written as time t2 minus t1, or which is also equal to what? Which is also equal to 2 pi by omega d. This we have already learned, time period, where tau is the time period. This can also be written as delta, can also be written as 1 by n ln of x1 by xn plus 1. This is also an expression for logarithmic decrement. From the definition, we have wrote this equation. And if I want to analyze for beginning amplitude to the final amplitude, the relation of logarithmic decrement with the ratios of amplitudes and the number of cycles is given by this equation. Now, to derive an expression for delta in terms of zeta, I should consider undamped vibrating system response. So here, if you observe, the amplitudes x1, x2, x3 are decreasing exponentially. If you draw a line, they will be decreasing exponentially, because the system response equation for an underdamped system is the function of e to the power of minus t. So hence, this decrement is in exponential form. Now, in order to eliminate the exponential form, I should take natural log. So hence, the name called logarithmic decrement. Now, let x1 be the amplitude of initial point and x2 be the amplitude of the second successive amplitude, and time taken for x1 be time t1 and time taken for to attain amplitude x2 be t2. Then what I can write for x1 and x2 by recalling the system response. By recalling system response equation of unadamped system, let me recall system response equation of unadamped system, which is given by x of t is equal to c4 e to the power of minus zeta omega nt cos of root of 1 minus zeta square omega nt plus phi 2. Correct? Now I want x1 and x2, so therefore I can write x1 and x2 as what? X1 will be equal to what? X1 will be equal to c4 e to the power of minus zeta omega n t1. X1 is at time t1 into cos of root of, so what I can write this term, root of 1 minus zeta square into omega n is damped natural frequency, right? So I'll write as omega d t t1 plus phi 2. So similarly amplitude x2 can be written as c4 e to the power of minus zeta omega n t2 cos of omega d t2 plus phi 2. Now I want the ratio x1 by x2. So take the ratio x1 by x2. So therefore x1 by x2 can be written as what? C4, C4 will get cancelled. So this will be simplified as e to the power of minus zeta omega n t1 t1 plus zeta omega n t2. Correct? So if I take the ratio, I will take the denominator to numerator, and then into what I have, cos of omega d t1 plus phi 2 divided by cos of omega d t2 plus phi 2. Now let us consider only this term and simplify first, and next we can simplify this equation further. Let me call it as equation number 4. This is equation 3 and 2, and this is equation number 1, system response equation. Now to simplify this one, let us consider only this term. So considering only the ratio, that is cos of omega d t1 plus phi 2 divided by cos of omega d t2 plus phi 2. Now we know what is the value of t2 in terms of time period tau. In terms of time period tau, I can write this as tau plus t1. T2 can be written as tau plus t1. Correct? Cos of omega d t1 plus phi 2 divided by cos of omega d tau plus t1 plus phi 2. This is because time period tau is equal to t2 minus t1. So since tau is equal to t2 minus t1, t2 can be written as tau plus t1. Now substitute for tau. We know the value of tau. What is the value of tau? Omega d t1 plus phi 2 divided by cos of omega d times omega d times tau is 2 pi by omega d plus t1 plus phi 2. Now if I multiply this inside, omega d will get cancelled, plus omega d t1 is what I left out with. So this is nothing but cos of omega d t1 plus phi 2 divided by cos of 2 pi plus omega d t1 plus phi 2. Now what is cos of 2 pi plus theta? Let me call this as theta. This is also theta. So cos of 2 pi plus theta is cos theta. So therefore these two are numerically same, hence I can cancel these two. Cos of 2 pi plus theta is cos theta. Cos of 2 pi plus theta is cos theta, hence these two are same. Hence this value is how much? 1. So what is that? That is cos of omega d t1 plus phi 2 divided by cos of omega d t2 plus phi 2, value is nothing but 1. So LHS remains same. So RHS I have simplified. So this term is nothing but 1. So therefore this value is nothing but unity. Hence the equation is completely simplified to the form x1 by x2 is equal to e to the power of zeta omega n. I can write it as t2 minus t1, correct? I can write it as t2 minus t1. Now what is t2 minus t1? T2 minus t1 is nothing but time period, right? So therefore it is minus zeta omega n time period. Now we know that the natural logarithmic ratio of two successive amplitudes is termed as logarithmic decrement. Hence what I should do now, I should take natural log on both sides. Take natural log on both sides. If I take natural log on both sides, that is log base e of x1 by x2 is equal to ln of e to the power of minus zeta omega n term. Log e into e to the power of something, that is a, is nothing but a. Therefore this will become minus zeta omega n into tau. Log of natural log of two successive amplitudes is nothing but delta, correct? So therefore delta will be minus zeta omega n into 2 pi by omega d. You know what is the value of omega d? Omega d is what? Omega d is root of 1 minus zeta square into omega n. So cancel of omega n and omega n. So here itself the negative sign is vanished, right? Why am I carrying negative sign? Negative sign is already vanished. Why am I taking negative sign again? We already simplified by interchanging the position, right? I wrote it as zeta omega n of t2 minus t1. So negative sign is already vanished. Hence the value of delta is how much? Hence the value of delta, this is from which equation? Equation 4. Substituting this term as unity, I got this. Next I substitute as tau, take a natural log on both sides, left side will become delta, and in right side it is log e, e to the power of a is nothing but a. Now I substitute for tau as 2 pi by omega d. Now substitute for omega d, that is root of 1 minus zeta square into omega n, cancel of omega n omega n. Hence I left out with delta is equal to 2 pi zeta by root of 1 minus zeta square. So this is the expression for logarithmic decrement in terms of damping ratio or damping factor. So this is the derivation for logarithmic decrement, wherein which we have derived relationship between logarithmic decrement and damping ratio or damping factor. If I know the damping coefficient C, mass and stiffness K, I can determine damping, critical damping coefficient. So damping coefficient is given. Critical damping coefficient is 2m omega n or 2 root mk. So I got C and CC, hence zeta is C by CC. If I know zeta, I can find delta. If I know delta, I can say what is the ratio of two successive amplitudes. You shift log to this side, it will become e to the power of delta. X1 by x2 will become e to the power of delta. Thereby I can say what is the value of x1 by x2. So like this, we can solve problems. You will get better understanding when I take numerical problems from next lecture. That's all from this lecture. Thank you all.